Okay, and welcome back. Our number three. We cover a lot of ground every night, 3 hours. Make of it what you will. Think of it what you'd like. Decide what your mind tells you, what works for you. I'm just here to try to present it to the best of my ability and our guests as well, so you can have a better shot at putting it all together. We've shown you some very compelling things, though, on the site. I mean, the videos of the helicopters, the muzzle flash, the shooting team on the Luxor muzzle flash, it's all there in the video. There's just no way around it. None. Zero. Our guest this hour is Preston James, author, researcher, writer. His materials are always provocative. They're right out there on the edge for a lot of people who haven't gone where Preston James goes, which is where his sources lead him and where his mind takes him. His current article is called The Second Hijacking of America, and it's up there right under his name, third in guests. So let's welcome Preston back. How are you?
I'm hanging in there. I'm doing pretty good, thanks to you, Jeff, because last time we talked, I was real sick. I had bronchitis. My wife started getting sick. You know, I'd had antibiotics for 2 weeks, and they didn't help, you know, so the conclusion is it's, you know, it's all viral, which it usually is anyway. And so I could hardly talk when I was, you know, talking to you or whatever. And
yeah.
He said, oh, I got the cure for that. And I'm always kind of skeptical, you know, naturopathic remedy. But anyway, you said, oh, I'll send you some Allison C overnight. I was so sick, I thought, okay, I'll try it. But I you know, it's hard for me to believe anything
right.
Works that fast when antibiotics didn't do anything. So I got it in the next day, overnight mail. So I followed your directions, 333, and then the next day, 321. And anyway, it completely took it all away for me in 2 days, for my wife, 1 day. So I was kind of shocked.
Oh, really? I didn't know he was going to talk about this, friend, so this is not a setup.
But it is true, though. I was, you know how sick I was.
Yeah.
And I was really kind of shocked, you know. So I mean, it really works.
It works.
That's all I can say.
It's nature's most astounding natural antiviral antibiotic. And I suspect you had a bacterium, but I don't know. It doesn't really matter. This Allison comes from garlic. It's an extraordinary discovery by Peter Jostling, a scientist in England, and it turns out that when a garlic clove is injured or bumped or cut or whatever, it releases two different compounds. It's called a binary. And they come together and create a third element out of the two. It's called Allison. And he stabilized Allison, and he's put it in capsules, and I had him add vitamin C. And we call it Allison C. And it is something you do not want to be without. I can't say the word cure. I could say it'll help build your immune system to a level that your immune system will take care of you in almost no time. It's remarkable. Remarkable. All right. Now, you've got a new essay up, The Second Hijacking of America. Terrific title. Great graphic. I like the graphic. That's good. So tell us what you're up to in this article. And I'd urge all of you to listen and then read it, because it'll soak in even better.
Well, of course, you see, nothing in this is anything that you didn't already know about. We haven't talked about most of it. But, I mean, Jeff, I think you were the first one to ever identify the fact this country was hijacked by world Zionists. Not Jewish people, but world Zionists. There's a huge difference. These are these Babylonian Talmudists.
That's
and
it.
Really, it's a satanic cult, a small group of people, you know, that run the money out of the city of London. And basically, it is a worldwide satanic cult. Nobody likes to admit that, but it just is. And they hijacked America in 1913 and it was all done illegally through bribing Congress and bribing the president, and very manipulating, mind controlling. But the bottom line is, it wasn't even passed legally. It was on a Christmas Eve night, and there was no legal quorum. And then, of course, anything like that that's so directly against the U.S. Constitution is null and void anyhow. So we've been living under the curse of this for over 100 years. And as you know, it was a 100-year agreement which expired, and they signed it again.
Right.
So the bottom line is, you know, our country was hijacked. And And like Meyer Amstel Ross, I said, I care not about the politics as long as I create the money, control the money. I don't worry.
Right. Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
And he figured it out. He knew.
You know, so basically we've been, I've had estimates from experts that say no matter what anybody says, we're paying approximately 40% of our federal taxes that go straight to interest on the national debt, which is phony. So that if we immediately canceled the federal debt, which is completely fraudulent, we would automatically have a reduction of 40% in our federal taxes. And I don't know how much that would affect the state taxes too, but quite a bit. So the bottom line is we are really being asset stripped and ripped off. And the thing is we have no control over the spending. It's like, you know, the Federal Reserve said, we have no review process. You know, whatever we say goes. You know, Alan Greenspan used to say that there is no review process. You know, we are the final say. So they can issue and print as much money as they want. They issue it to foreign banks and just keep printing, issuing, printing, issuing. But the more they print and issue, and the more they become an elastic checkbook to Congress, the more they charge the taxpayer interest. So it's a complete total scam. It's a debt machine. And what they've done is they created a web of debt that has really entrapped almost every American except for the up.
Preston, are you there?
Some of the things I'm going to say tonight will not be allowed by the old guard. The new people actually like this stuff. We're in the midst of a coup d'etat right now. You know that, Jeff.
So it's not on the front pages, but there are tremendous forces at work.
Yeah. And so, you know, basically the Hillary crowd, the Bush, you know, Bush, it was the, let's just say, ran the Hillary and Bill Clinton crowd. And there was they tried to stage a coup d'etat to manipulate the election and take over. And of course, Hillary was just a shill for the banksters. And if she'd gotten in, we'd be in World War III with Iran right now. We'd be fighting wars for greater Israel all over the Middle East and American troops getting blown to pieces.
That's right. That's right.
So,
absolutely.
Basically, the fact that we have three generals in the White House now is not a coincidence. They picked Donald Trump. They put him in there. One of the generals I don't like. The other two I do like. One of them CFR. But the bottom line is
McMaster.
Right. That was a counter coup against the this satanic cabal, the pizza eaters, I call them.
But the pizza eaters. You know, yeah. General Flynn was really echoing what Trump said during the campaign, that the Muslims had to go. They don't work. They don't belong here. And they got rid of him.
But General Flynn didn't do anything wrong. All his stuff he was doing with Turkey was all intelligence work. He was doing it as a covert operation. And he didn't do anything wrong. And he's a good, I like him. He's a good man.
Yep.
I think it screwed him over.
Well, if you heard the first hour tonight, we covered that pretty thoroughly. Yeah.
So the average person studying this looks like the Bush-Clinton crowd staged a coup to take over to fight all these wars for Israel. They wouldn't need another 911. They'd just take over. That was what it was. And the military stepped in and did a counter coup. That's what everybody thinks. That's the subplot. The real plot is that our government got too close to aliens starting 50 years ago, and they've been all mind-controlled and shaped by them, and most of them don't even know it. And this is a major coup d'etat by aliens that have taken over our society, and they're going to... The one thing that's really strange is, have you noticed how all the Khazarians are going down lately? Harvey Weinstein and... You know,
they're hanging a lot of their own out to dry. I don't know what the game is. Something's going on, though.
I'll tell you what it is. In the military, they all know in various places in the Pentagon, in the high military, that, and especially the Navy, they know, you know, remember the Naval Intelligence Section was hit, you know, when the U.S. Air Force fired a cruise missile into the Pentagon.
Yep.
So, yeah. So the bottom line is they know that Israel and these traitors in our government did 9/11. They know that. And every single person involved, they're going to take down one way or the other. Now, you know, I don't think they're going to terminate them. I think what they're going to do is remove them from power. Maybe they'll send them into exile. I don't know what they're going to do, but I will tell you that the word I'm getting is it's over for the Khazarians. They're done. And you're going to see them knocked down one by one. It's already starting. You know, you got that senator from Minnesota, Al Franken. He's going down. They're all going down.
You know, I want to say one other thing, that many of the people, the males, being accused for sexual crimes, perversion, there are a lot of different terms for it. Many of them just happen to be Jewish.
Well, actually, the word Jew didn't even come into existence in 750 AD. It's a synthetically created race.
Whatever they are, however you wish to label them, there are a lot of them that are Zionist, dual citizen, Israeli, quote, Jews.
And not as many as you think. It's really a small, the Israelis are Khazarian, 97% of them, but they're used as cutouts. The world Zionists, what they did is they were behind the work camps in Germany. Hitler was a dual agent. He worked for the Rothschilds. He was mind controlled. He had a Jewish doctor that kept him drugged up all the time, sleeping pills to go to sleep. And
I read that doctor's biography or his.
Yeah. So, I mean, and Greg Hallett, you know, studied this. Greg Hallett got hold of all the MI5 and MI6 files. He had them all dumped on him when he was in New Zealand. And Hitler worked for him the whole time. He was a British agent. He was mind controlled at Tavistock Institute in 1920 and 21. And he was a Rothschild, had 1/4 Rothschild blood. So the bottom line is that the Nazis went into business with alien ETs, and they got a lot of technology. There was a crash in Bavaria in 1922, and a number of them, and then the real girls appeared with the long hair, and they were serving as some kind of medium, but they were drawing plans for anti-gravity and giving it to them. Many people think that the real girls were alien hybrids because some of the stuff they did I can't talk about, but let's just say they were so good looking that they could get physical control over any man within 20 minutes and get him to do anything that they wanted. So.
Or less.
Well, or less. That's right, depending on the man, yeah. But these, you know,
what was her name, the famous one of the real girls? I can't remember her name.
They were really, I mean, they were beautiful women. Yeah. There's no doubt about that. They really were. But they were smart.
Right.
And there are some left today, too, by the way. So, the bottom line is the Nazis went into business with these various species, but they were told these weapons we're going to give you can only be used for defensive purposes if you misuse any of this stuff. That's why the Nazis developed the V2, the V1 and the V2. That was not alien stuff. But they had anti-gravity craft. They had the Bell, which was kind of like a potential. But the aliens just said, if you start using any of this stuff for offensive weapons, we're done with you. Well, they started using it for offensive weapons, and the aliens divorced them. And so at that point, 1943, Cameron and these various people negotiated with, through back channels, with British intelligence and American intelligence. Mm-hmm. Said, look, Hitler's nuts. He's going to lose the thing. He does everything wrong. We told him not to go after the Russians, and he did. He's a maniac. He let everybody go at Dunkirk. You know, the guy is he's a British, told him that, you know, you work for us and we're going to combine forces and take care of the Russians together, to get rid of the Soviets together, And then, of course, they turned on him for some reason. Was because of the way Hitler was handling the money. Who knows? Maybe that was their script all along. So then Hitler, the Nazis never surrendered at the end of the war. The German army did, but the Nazis were all given immunity. And
well, I think they have a treaty, and I think it's still in effect today. Because they got paperclip out of it. We let them all go to Argentina, Paraguay, and we've covered that for so many hours. Yeah.
We had to get something for it, and what the deal was, we got all their technology, we got their plutonium, which, we didn't have enough plutonium to bomb Japan twice. A lot of the plutonium was German plutonium. You knew that, right?
That's correct.
Yeah. And the...
came from, I forget which U-boat it came from, but the one that surrendered.
And here's the interesting part. The detonators that were put in the bombs were put in by a woman, not a man.
Now, that is interesting. I didn't know that.
Yeah. You see, she was the best. Actually, I know who she is. I know where she was from. Mm-hmm. I know her son. But anyway, the bottom line is, the United States would do anything to get this technology, and they were very fearful the Russians were getting it. And of course, they were both fighting over these scientists. Well, the Germans figured, let's go to America. That's pretty nice there. But so what happened is you had guys like Wernher von Braun, who was a repentant Nazi. He says, I'm going to be a good boy now. But he was obsessed with rockets. He loved liquid rockets and all that kind of stuff. He didn't care about the anti-gravity stuff or any of that stuff. He loved rockets, big rockets. So, of course, he comes over and sets up the space program here at NASA. And then you also have the secret Nazi part of it, which was anti-gravity stuff, which was totally isolated from everybody, including Wernher von Braun. He knew nothing about it. And it was in, you know, deepest, darkest secret places. So at that point, the United States, you know, started having crashes, you know, that they would recover. There were a number of them in this country. I think the first one was 1938. But finally you had Roswell, where you had dead aliens and I think one or two alive ones. And, you know, so the rest is history. Then our government at first admitted there was a flying saucer that crashed, then they locked it down and said, oh, no, it was a weather balloon. And then eventually they said it was Project Mogul, you know, dummy test dummies dropped from the sky and all that. But the bottom line was there were way too many witnesses that saw a live alien, one or two live aliens and dead bodies. And, you know, the mortuary would deliver, you know, children-sized caskets to the airbase, all that kind of stuff. So they, you know, they just basically been lying since 1947. Bottom line is there have been a number of treaties made between our government and alien ETs. And, you know, we had some in captivity and communicated with them in various ways. The average alien had anywhere between 200 and 600 IQ compared to humans.
Well, see, when you say communicated with them, that's very interesting because it also has been suggested that communicating with them actually resulted in them taking control of whoever was doing the communications. And that's why a lot of them were killed.
That's right.
We could not control them.
And the worst part was, though, that a lot of the mind control they did was unknown to the person being controlled. The best mind control is when the person that's being mind controlled has no awareness of it.
That's right.
So basically what happened is, you know, they made various treaties and said, you can, you know, they said, look, we come from another planet. Our star system and our DNA is decaying and we need some of yours. We want some of your animal DNA and your human DNA. We have to repair our DNA. That's all we really want. And of course they were lying. Everything an alien has ever said turns out to be a lie or a twisted or deceptive. But, the secret space war program of the American, these people were so desperate for this technology, they would look the other way. One treaty was that they would, abduct people and they could do it as long as they wouldn't hurt the people and they would, you know, use anesthesia when they take samples and then erase their minds so they'd never have a memory and then release them. But they had to, you know, put an identifying crystal in them and then keep records, give the records to the U.S. Air Force. Well, or the Navy. And so what happened was, after a period of time, one of their UFOs crashed and it had body parts on it. Looked like a, you know, like a butcher shop, like they were eating them, cooking them and eating them.
He's talking about human body parts. Yeah.
Right. You know, and this, of course, sent shockwaves to it. So, you know, what the heck's going on here? But again, the decision was made, okay, we'll bitch about it and this and that, but we need that technology no matter what. And the main argument was, is the old X-File stuff that, you know, we're going to have to play ball with it because if we don't get the technology they have, we won't be able to defend ourselves against them. The plan was, and of course, the supposed good alien group they were working with told them, okay, you know, we're fighting these same bad aliens, two of these Dracos, you know, the dragons, the people that run the, you know, the tall whites and some of these alien groups would tell them, the Dracos are serpentine, you know, reptilian things, and they're the bad ones, and they, you know, they shapeshift and they control the banking in England, and this is where Zionism comes from.
Uh-huh.
But we'll help you. Okay, so now, you know, the secret space war program people are buried in all these unacknowledged deep black and beyond black programs. They're almost separate subculture societies. They've been completely conned by the aliens. The aliens have You've gotten them convinced that the Khazarians are really reptilians, or they're being controlled by reptilians, and the Zionists are really the offspring of it, reptilians, shape-shifting reptilians. So they're going to go after and get them all, help us clean house, because they're their enemies too. So this particular unit has taken, this is weird stuff, Jeff, but this is what I think is going on. So they've taken over, basically, the most powerful unit in our government right now is in the secret shadow government, and it's these deep black and beyond black space war units that are not even acknowledged by the defense contractors they're in. They have a secret budget. They raise their own funds. They have their own army. And let's just say take, I don't know if this would be one company, but somebody like T-Systems or Raytheon. Or Lockheed, if one of these programs was located in one of those companies, the CEO, the board of directors, would never even be allowed to know that they were there because they don't have high enough security clearances. They don't have a 237. They don't have a cosmic clearance. Is that bizarre or what?
Yeah.
So these units, they use drugs to raise money. They have all kinds of scams. They do a lot of counterfeiting. They get money whatever way they want, but they always have plenty of money. Okay, so they got their own money. They got their own operatives. They got their own agents. And of course, there's been rumors for years about MIBs, that MIBs are really either aliens that can, you know, cloak a human appearance, or are alien human hybrids.
But hard to know. I don't know the answer to that one. I really couldn't even guess. I don't know. Don't know. Hold on a minute, and Preston and I will be right back. His current article is right under his name, and just click and read, and there are a couple videos embedded in it. It's another classic from Preston James. Be right back. And we continue with Preston James, whose current article up there really touches a lot of bases. All right, why is it that they continue with this asinine ET cover-up when they've been prepping us for over 60 years since the 1950s sci-fi movies came out? Aren't we ready, Preston? When are they going to give up this stupid cover-up that very few intelligent people will subscribe to anymore?
Well, I think that there's so much inertia there. They have so many different layers of secrecy, and there's all kinds of games that they play in different levels between each other, that there would be a massive loss of power. If they came out and said, we've been lying through our teeth, you know, we've spent $2 trillion a year underground and in outer space programs and spying on you. $2 trillion a year, out of a budget of $3.3 trillion. That's why everybody's asset stripped. Now, if they ever admitted that, the people would want to hang them all. It'd be like guillotine time coast to coast for all these government officials. There wouldn't be one person left in Congress.
See, I ask you this question quasi-rhetorically because I don't expect them to admit anything. If it happens, it'll happen on its own without their necessarily being in control of it. Something will happen, they won't be able to explain their way out of it. It'll be that simple. They'll have to act dumb and say, well, gee, this is the first we've heard of this. You know, that kind of thing.
Well, I think the big threat for them right now is Putin, because
he could let the cat out of the bag and never go back.
Well, he's threatened to do that, and also that, you know, the Chinese have a secret treaty with aliens that look a little Chinese too, which is kind of interesting. But you know, nobody wants to deal with this stuff really, because the public doesn't want to believe. It's okay to fantasize it and watch X-Files and all that, but deep down inside, I don't think people really want this to be true. Because if it is, a lot of people question their own, their religious beliefs.
Well, you know, yes. I think religion is fading, not in the third world or the second world, but certainly in the first world. Attendance is down and all that. But I think that basically intelligent people, I think they would welcome it. So they could tell all these politicians, the AIPAC party, which includes the Democrats and the Republicans, could tell them all to go to hell. And I think you're right about they'd still play the game. They don't want to go to jail, so they know who's got the guns. We do, but so do the feds, and we'll end up in jail. So they'd continue to play the game. But I really do think that most intelligent people would just shrug their shoulders and laugh.
Yeah. Well, I think it's the amount of asset stripping. The fact that if the public ever found out that they were selling massive amounts of
narcotics. Oh, absolutely.
Human sex trafficking, organ trafficking, all these things to pay for all this stuff.
That's right.
Taking every dime they can, you know.
That's right. That's right.
Bus off for. That's where the rub would come. But you know, the bottom line is right now we have a situation where we're living in a state of martial law. The military, three generals in the White House, they're running the White House. They're running everything. They picked Trump, and we don't really know where it's all going.
No.
People that know Trump say he's got an IQ over 200. He's extremely crafty. He sets people up all the time, puts them into traps. We really don't know where this is all going. He may come out a lot better than what people think. We don't know. Maybe other people said, oh, he's a Zionist shill. I don't know, to tell you the truth. I think we're going to just have to wait and see.
Well, but Kushner is a real big key to whether or not Trump is a Zionist shill or not. Kushner's in there. He shouldn't be in there. He has no business in there. He might as well be have his name tag in front of him at the JCS meetings. Mossad, Jerry Kushner. I don't know.
The bottom line is, you know, the secret space war is so powerful now. They have the mind control technology. They have the various tools to control the politicians. They've got the NSA. They've got control over the NSA now. And, you know, the NSA has the Vesuvius, a new quantum computer. They no longer need to tap into lines. They can tap into any electronic circuit directly from satellites and from aircraft without, they don't need an actual contact. You know that, don't you?
Yep. Well, I've heard it. I don't know it, but yes, I have heard it.
Well, that's what I've been told. And so basically there is no more secrecy, and they have access to all the deepest, dirtiest secrets of all the politicians. You know, and that's what the FBI specialized in for years, and the CIA was human compromise. And the CIA would traffic in little children and set people up for pedophile stuff, all kinds of ways. Sometimes they'd drug them and then throw them in bed with a young kid, and when nothing happened, they just take the pictures. Then the host comes in and says, oh, what happened? Well, don't you worry, you know, you drank too much and got too frisky now. We'll cover it all up for you. Don't you worry.
You know, and you just made a very good point. Nothing necessarily needed to have happened.
No.
You just end up with a picture of a little kid in bed with you, and you're toast.
That's right. So they have all that stuff on file. But you see now, this various sector inside the secret space war program at either deep black or beyond black level has access to everything. There are no more secrets to them, so they can take any of this intel any place.
Mm-hmm.
And they can use this to manipulate. So they can go to a politician, and they can, you know, the typical thing is they stick a manila envelope under the door during the night. You know, the janitor does, and they come and open up, and there's a picture, one of these pictures. And then the message is, you know, you'll be receiving a call at 8:05 this morning or something like that. And they tell them, here's your instructions, you know.
Yeah, we need you to do this, and that's it.
And you'll never hear about us again. Of course, the answer is until
until next time.
Yeah, and so now, but you see, now the Khazarians are all going down for 9-1-1. So what I think has happened is the aliens have conned these, you know, various, let's just say, high military that are involved in the secret space war program, saying, look, this is why we're having all the problems. Look what these guys did. We got to have payback. You need to get them out. You need to take over, put in a new system, and let's redo the whole world our way. Let's get it all fixed up and stuff. So we really don't know where this is all going. I can tell you right now, the secret space war program is in control. It also involves Russia and China. There is a space council. So like some people say that MJ's expanded to over 100 people. And it's not like it used to be. The young people and the old people, and the young people are sort of pushing them out. Some of them want disclosure. Some of them want limited disclosure. But they have treaties between them that we're not going to use secret space war weapons against each other. We're here to defend ourselves against, there's an alien attack coming in the future, and we're going to gear up for it.
Nice.
And it's a great cover story. So, but I think they've all been conned by the aliens. I think they've all been mind controlled, and I don't even think they know.
How could we possibly think we're going to come out on top dealing with a species that is totally telepathic and has an IQ of double ours minimum? There's no way we're going to control anything.
I mean, there's over 200 cases where abductions have been stopped cold because people called on the name of Jesus. You've probably heard that.
I've heard that for years.
Yeah. Well, I'm one of them, okay?
And, wow.
And there's also another deterrent. You know the time my wife and I were attacked in broad daylight?
Yes. Yeah,
okay. And I don't want to talk about it. People say, oh, you have no witnesses. No, I got a witness. She didn't believe it either before it happened. But no. I will say, they're very afraid of guns. That's one of the reasons they want to disarm people, because they do bleed and they do die. It's like a bluish green blood. They do die. And the gun is they're most afraid of is .22 for some reason. And I don't know why, but they want to. Yeah.
Huh.
Small caliber for some reason. One of the stories is if they have clothing that will stop bigger projectiles, but it won't stop anything that small.
So, well, .22 is pretty close to a .223 when you think about it. The velocity is night and day, but that's .223 caliber, almost 5.56 NATO rounds.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, so, you know, I don't want to believe in this stuff. I don't like to believe in this stuff. If I hadn't had some actual events happen, I wouldn't believe any of it. I hadn't had reports from, people that were involved in the intel business that investigated this and were shut down at a higher level, I wouldn't believe any of it. It's taken 30 years of dealing with this stuff for me to really believe it. I don't like to believe it. But there is something going on there. It's buried in secrecy. Up until two, three years ago, they were killing anybody that talked about it. This particular article would have gotten me iced in about 24 hours 3 years ago. They don't care anymore. So does that mean that they want disclosure? Maybe. Is it possible disclosure's coming? Apparently, the aliens had told them they wanted disclosure by 2015, and if they didn't get it, they were going to do it themselves. And if you see some of the shows on the, you know.
By 2015.
That was the date they wanted disclosure by.
Well, they're 2 years late.
Right. Well, they said that if humans didn't do it by 2015, they would start doing it themselves. Now, if you look at all these shows on television, Hangar One and all these various things, maybe they're preparing the public, you know.
Well, they've been doing that for 70 years, though, since 1950.
Some of the stuff on there is really, I've been shocked by it.
Yeah. Think about it. I haven't seen television. I don't have it. Are there good E.T. dramas on now? Is that what you're saying? There's some pretty good scripts and things.
No, I think there's more like historical views. You know, Hangar One was probably the best where they had the actual evidence. But, you know, the X-Files is I would say if anybody that watches certain of the X-Files stuff would get the closest picture to what's really going on. I think it's very realistic.
Chris Carter had some inside information. There's no doubt about that. No.
Well, there was rumor that he had a visit from the FBI, wanted to know where he was getting his information because it was coming from their files and they wanted to know how.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
Well, obviously Mulder was stealing it, giving it to Carter.
I don't think the show was a mistake. I think at a very high level, they made the decision that they wanted that out there.
Well, it was extremely well done. And, you know, they're just finishing now producing 10 more episodes.
Oh, wow.
Did you know
that? They would have stopped it. Yeah, I didn't know that. But, Jeff,
10 more.
If they didn't want it out there, they would have shut it down.
Oh, of course. 10 more episodes, and two of them are supposed to be the A story, the A plot line. That's the E.T. plot line, and the other eight are standalones, meaning paranormal this and paranormal that. But 10 more episodes, that's a major statement.
Well, it is. I was told that disclosure will come as soon as we have complete weapons parity with the aliens.
How's that going to happen?
Well, they claim they're very close. They're a year or two away from it. This is what I've been told.
I find that difficult to believe, but I don't have all the answers, but that is
back
an odd one.
Of MIBS, though, you haven't heard about MIBS lately, but you know,
nothing.
10 years.
You know what else you haven't heard about? Abductees. It's out of the news.
That's right. But MIBs were very interesting because the first MIBs wore dark brown suits. They had blocky heads and stuff. And it was a Fort Kelly, you know, it was an Air Force base. They would recruit all these weird looking soldiers with, you know, really weird, you know, characteristics and then dress them up and put them in old cars and send them out to freak people out. You know, you shouldn't be reporting any of this. Some, you get some 6'5" monster at your door dressed in a brand new suit driving a 10-year-old brand new Cadillac. It freaked people out. What are they going to call cops that I had two aliens come and threaten me? That doesn't work too good. So, you know, that was, they were actual, you know, Air Force people, Kelly Air Force Base. But then there were some real MIBs that were smaller guys in black dressed in real life. But some people said their faces were cloaked if you looked at them, or if they got angry, their faces would become distorted so you couldn't see any features. I mean, there were, you know, these probably were alien hybrids or aliens. So,
okay. And, all right, here's a question.
Yeah. I mean, it's so clouded.
What about these videos that allege to show somebody shape-shifting on a digital video or a VHS tape years ago?
Yeah.
There are video recordings of people speaking, or they're powerful people, and they are alleged to show them shimmer and shape shift into a non-humanoid and then back to human.
I've always thought they were fake, but I can tell you, Greg Hallett is a very interesting guy. He had to leave New Zealand because he got involved in he was a very well-to-do architect and ran into trouble with the courts, and they were all totally crooked. And then he found out that the royal family was involved in major drug dealing and all this stuff. And, you know, he's quite a guy, but he ran into this guy he called the Spymaster, who was a retired MI5, MI6 guy that gave him access to all the files. And so, and he learned all this stuff. And so he was in court fighting this one case. And when people left the room, he said something to the judge, and the judge got so angry at him. He said he saw him shapeshift into, like, his head turned into like a lizard head for about a tenth of a second. And I said, you got to be kidding me. And he said, no, it's really, Greg doesn't lie. And there's other people who have said things like that. So this guy was part of the royal family. So, but the bottom line is, you know, we've heard reports of that for years. I don't know if I would trust a film or anything like that. But, you know, there have been reports for over 1,000 years of that kind of stuff. David Icke, people have criticized him for years. But, you know, I've always said I think he's telling the truth about what he knows. I think he's right. I think he's got a lot of really good stuff, and most people just can't make the jump to the shape-shifting stuff. That's a basic tenet of his teaching. But I think he's great.
His new book is out now, and he was about to have a big book launch get together at apparently a stadium where Manchester United plays in England, and it was shut down by the Zionists. And he was very upset about it. I have the story up. I got a video. A whole bunch of David Icke supporters got together. They found a different venue, and they got a huge amount of free publicity, and they've launched the book anyhow. Now, I have a video up with David. I don't know if you've been able to hear it or not, but he was on a week and a half ago.
And I heard that. Oh, yeah.
You heard it?
Yes, I did.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, it's good. It's all there. It's the same kind of thing that we've been talking about here for a long time, and he's putting in the book now. The thing with David is he's taken the gloves off about talking about Zionist Jews.
He is
no longer shielding. He's telling it straight, and I salute that. That take a lot of courage from anybody. And
but Jeff, there's been a lane change. See, you're no longer a target if you talk about it anymore. Yeah, they can mess you a little bit, but it used to whack people for that kind of stuff. They're on the run now. Their day's over. They're all being pushed out. The whole world Zionist system's coming down on their heads bit by bit. You just watch it happen. And the people behind it is probably the secret space war program. They're the people that were behind putting Trump in. I don't know what their agenda is. I just hope we end up with something better than what we've had, but you never know.
It is interesting.
And Jeff, you've known about a lot of this stuff for years, but you know, it's kind of discrediting to talk about this stuff too much because I don't like to believe it. Most people don't want to hear it. And so, you know, now we've got, you know, some movies. In my article, I got a KGB movie of a little gray, and it's not fake or anything else. So there are movies now, and you know, we're getting much, much better evidence. So.
Well, the conundrum is when ever a movie or a video shows up that is real, people always say, well, we're in the digital age now. How can you prove it? And there's really no proof. So the controllers have an easy out on this. They can show anything they want now, because people will always question, is it digital manipulation? Is it CGI? Is it FX? What is it? So, interesting. Very interesting.
So let me ask you a question. Okay. You don't like to get into this stuff too much, do you?
I've spent so many hours on this program in 24 years talking with abductees and experiencers and people who have seen things they can't understand, thousands of them. And no, I have no problem with it. There just aren't many out there right now that I can get hold of who have really good experiences that want to share them. I'm not saying it's not happening. I'm just saying I don't know why, but I'm not seeing many. They're not coming across the desk. I'd be happy to have more of them on. Doesn't bother me.
I think for whatever reasons, the frequency's down, but there are a lot of people that disappear in national parks. You know that, right?
Yes, I've done programs with the author of those three books that are out now.
Well, I have a friend who went to a national park, and he said that the forest ranger that was running it looked like an alien and acted really super weird. They didn't even want to stay. They got out of there. So you know, and then you start checking, you find out of all the people missing.
Lots of people missing. It's called Missing 411, the name of his books.
And this is not a joke.
He's
either.
A former cop, by the way.
Yeah, that's right. And it's very well documented, but it's not a joke. And the thing is, you know, I think it's an alien hunting ground myself. You know, there are different alien groups, but I think some of the aliens eat people. That's my own view.
Well, wouldn't surprise me. Nothing does. We have pictures of mutilated people, just like mutilated cattle, mutilated horses, mutilated dogs and cats, you name it. And they've been mutilated all in the same fashion, all in the same technique. So, yes, there are people who have presented the exact same profile. And I don't know what to tell you. Organs missing. And I'm sure that of all the people missing, there are probably a lot of people who have been taken.
Yeah.
And there are multiple different so-called intelligent advanced species coming and going here. Who knows? I don't know. But I agree with you. X-Files on balance is probably the best. You mentioned Hangar. What did you say? What did you call it?
Hangar 1.
Hangar 1.
Repeated quite, but they've had some really good stuff on there. And
is that like a long-running series?
Yeah, I think it is. There was maybe for a couple of years, but they have repeats all the time. But Jeff, something has to give pretty soon, don't you think?
Sure. Oh, yeah.
You go to South America, and why are there so many sightings in South America? They're all over the place. Some people say it's because the Nazi took their secret space war program down there, and they have, you know, UFOs.
Yeah, I don't think so. I talked to doggone it, what was his name? The former guy used to write for the National Enquirer, who went down to South America and went into the smallest little villages he could find out in the middle of nowhere, and he had the same stories from every village about ETs and ships coming overhead. And what's that?
Why are there so many alien sightings down?
I don't know, but it's almost like the world's been chopped up into different spheres of influence for these visitors. That may be part of it, too. I don't know. He said that the profile of visitation down there and sighting was completely different than that in North America and different than that in Europe. So I don't know. You just ask the questions. So thank you, Preston. Go get some rest. Great article, as always, and we'll look forward to talking to you next time.
Take care, Jeff.
Okay, thank you. Preston James, and you can find his articles archived on the left-hand side of the homepage. So enjoy and learn.